The Tamarigim branch of the United Cadets Front, a group affiliated to the National Democratic Congress, has called on the Akufo-Addo-led New Patriotic Party government to speed up investigations into the killings that happened last year in the course of the 2020 general elections. They said it is long overdue for the Ghana Police Service and the government to have concluded investigations into the killings that took place in some of the constituencies on voting day, where 8 people were gruesomely murdered. At a press conference in Tema, the chairman of the group, Oliver Agbenyo Ahiafo, demanded justice so as to bring peace to the soul of the departed while bringing joy to the bereaved family.
Ladies and gentlemen of the media, as you may know, before, during, and after 2020 polls, a lot of violence occurred across Ghana. Up to about 22 incidents, including 8 killings, dozens of clashes and firearms. This was a major blot on Ghana's fledgling democracy. The killing of the 8 men and women in particular cast a shadow over our country's stable democracy. We, the United Cadets Front of Tema region, took and still take a serious view of the state-sponsored targeting, violence, and killings that ensued before, during, and after the 2020 elections. We are utterly shocked that after all this torrid spectacle, the government of Ghana has been loudly silent on these happenings and has neglected and refused to act. Not even a statement to at least give a flicker of hope to the family of the victims that this injustice befell. We condemn in no uncertain terms these incidents. It is worth noting that these stroke government to act and bring these perpetrators of this heinous crime to book before the next elections. We want to send a strong signal to the government and its state-sponsored vigilantes that we will be battle ready to respond in multiple measures if this thuggery and violence recurs in 2024 elections.
Other members of the group also have this to say.
That at any given time, when there's any elections, there shouldn't be any people with armed police or any other armed people over there, because we know that at any given time, when there's any elections, there shouldn't be any people with armed police or any other armed people over there, because we know we are going to exercise our civic distance. And I believe if it is only 2 at a polling station, it will serve the right. But here we are, we saw a number of people, because people were just saying transparency, and they were trying to make sure that whatever they have done, they have voted, must come to light. People were trying to find a ways and means to suppress them. So I don't think another time we should entertain any armed police or military people over there, whether they are even from regular or this thing, we shouldn't allow them. That is one area we are pushing the government.
The leader to look upon the people and share the national cake equally. He looks upon himself. And if somebody prophesied that if we don't take time and we allow this monetization to enter into politics, we will cry one day, and this is the regime. A regime of evil, and democracy has become a deity. That if you manage yourself into democracy and you receive the power of the people, then you can do whatever you like, and this is the regime.
The group also alleged that the New Patriotic Party government has succeeded in making itself the worst government ever in the history of Ghana by sponsoring the killings of 8 persons in an election-related clashes.
It is worth noting that these thuggery were done by state-sponsored security agents. In other words, these were state-sponsored thuggery on innocent citizens of this country. The NPP has always demonstrated and take pride in the all die be die mantra, by which was initiated by their leader, President Nana Addo-Dankwa Akufo-Addo, and has become their political philosophy. We have seen the extreme show of brutish force by this government and its assignees. The NPP government, led by Nana Addo-Dankwa Akufo-Addo and Dr. Bawumia, has succeeded in making itself the worst government ever in the history of this country, Ghana, by sponsoring killings of these eight individuals who had done nothing wrong, trusted to guarantee the safety of the ordinary Ghanaian, particularly ahead of the 2024 polls. The president was and is still responsible for the acts of lawlessness we have witnessed since his government assumed power. He has orchestrated and supervised activities of so-called vigilante groups. Clearly, by this performance, Nana Addo-Dankwa Akufo-Addo is the worst leader in the history of this country. The despotic regime has sent fear and panic down the spine of every citizenry. The Cadres Front strongly avers and warns that violence can't be a sole preserve of only a group of people and